So this is a really exciting time for vitiligo. There's a lot of great research coming down the pipeline. We're learning a lot more about the pathogenesis of vitiligo, and that's allowing us to better understand therapeutic targets for treating it. So one of the most exciting things that we're now seeing clinical trials occur for are JAK inhibitors. And so we're looking at JAK1/2 and JAK1/3 inhibitors, both orally and topically, for treating melasma. And there's been some promising data so far from case reports and small trials that show that patients can benefit, particularly in photoexposed sites. So I think that's really promising and exciting as in terms of a targeted therapeutic option. And then the other new medication that we're going to see more trials on is alpha-melanocyte, which already had gone through some trials in the US and then was undergoing trials overseas. But that's an alpha-melanocyte-stimulating hormone that, in combination with phototherapy, has also shown really promising results. So these are both very exciting new options that's going to offer our patients new things compared to the traditional phototherapy and steroid treatments that we've been offering. So I think it's really important for vitiligo patients to first assess what type of vitiligo that they have, because that's really going to affect their response to treatment. And so first you want to categorize them as either segmental or non-segmental. Segmental vitiligo, we know, doesn't tend to respond as well to traditional vitiligo therapies. It actually tends to do really well with surgical grafting. And there's been a lot of new modifications to surgical grafting that allow us to have really beautiful results. If they have non-segmental vitiligo, you want to categorize them into either having focal or generalized vitiligo. Is it unilateral? And so depending on the distribution of their vitiligo and also the activity of it, and the subtype of it, then you can sort of decide on prognosis. There are several subtypes of vitiligo that have been documented in the literature recently, such as confetti vitiligo. We know about trichrome vitiligo. There's inflammatory vitiligo. All of those are subtypes that indicate increased disease activity, and so you'd want to be a little bit more aggressive and proactive about treatment with those patients. So once you've assessed all of that, then you can really decide on what's the appropriate, treatment regimen for them, and you can discuss prognosis and expectations with the patient about how long that treatment will take and what to expect at different time points. So I think another exciting and interesting topic that comes up a lot with patients that have vitiligo is the impact of diet and supplements. And patients always want to know, are there certain vitamins I should take? Should I be on a certain diet for vitiligo? And when you look at the literature, currently there are no controlled studies looking at diet for vitiligo. And we've only seen benefit in a few case reports of doing a gluten-free diet in patients that have celiac disease. Otherwise, we really don't have data to support patients even doing gluten-free diet or really any other diet with vitiligo. We do know that there's a lot of oxidative stress in the pathogenesis of vitiligo, and these patients have increased reactive oxygen species. And so because of that, there is a theory that antioxidants could really help suppress that. And there are a handful of studies that have been done, limited number that have actually been randomized controlled trials, which actually show that antioxidants in combination with phototherapy can help with disease stabilization and can help augment repigmentation. Some of these vitamins have included vitamin C, vitamin E, alpha-lipoic acid. There's also certain plants that have been studied, such as ginkgo biloba, polypodium lycodamos, and all of these have had small but promising data results that show that we may be able to use this as adjunctive therapy for vitiligo to help stabilize disease. So I think that's an area that we need more studies on, but I think something else to consider in our therapeutic armamentarium for vitiligo patients.